After 4 years of behind-the-scenes negotiating, Machrihanish Airbase has been officially handed over to the community in Kintyre. The former airbase was bought from the Ministry of Defence by Machrihanish Airbase Community Company for the princely sum of £1. The site has more than 200 buildings, one of Europe's longest runways, and 1,025 acres of land. There are around 14 miles of road on the site, with leisure facilities including tennis and squash courts, as well as a shooting range. Scottish Environment Minister Stuart Stevenson visited the site on Monday, May 28, 2012.
I think with the capabilities of the base and the substantial investments that the military have made over the years, there is the potential there for the buyout company to bring in companies. It may be a one-man or two-man business that wants some office accommodation. That's going to provide the capability of creating jobs. It might be more substantial issues in manufacturing if we can further expand the capabilities of the site, building on the hundreds of jobs that we already have. It could well be that if we are able to use the accommodation blocks, there'll be service jobs associated with that. So I think this site offers such a variety of options that I know that the company are looking at and talking to a range of people that will create these opportunities. This is a developed site with industrial capability, and I'm delighted to see two wind turbine companies on the site. It's a potential for tourism. We've got the officers' mess that could be used for a wide variety of purposes. There's accommodation for people here, and of course it provides the lifeline airport services that the Mull of Kintyre depends on as well.
The next steps are to hold a public meeting in the Victoria Hall and bring the public fully up to speed with where we are, the packages of money that we've received and that from the MOD and Scottish Government, and where we intend to spend that money and develop the site in going forward. We want to talk to the public, get their ideas for the future use, and expand the ideas that we have for the site. It's going to create jobs in the area. It's going to create opportunities for even local companies to expand. Yes, we've had a lot of interest over the last 4 years, but because obviously it's taken us so long, we have to rekindle some of that interest, and that's what we'll be busy doing the rest of this year, is to get more of these companies back, to get sitting round the table and talk to them, reference bringing different types of industry and different types of projects into the area here.
I'm quite confident with the help and support that's required, Mark will bring jobs to the area and also create opportunities for local businesses within the RAF base. I think it's a very positive step for the local community, and I'd like to think that businesses would come on here which would be sustainable small businesses, and it would help the overall picture in Kintyre in the long term. We're at a difficult time at the moment with the financial crisis in the country, but I still feel there's ample opportunity here for people to invest in the area. But we need the key partners such as Highlands and Islands Development, Scottish Government, and particularly our Island Butte Council to play their part if this is going to become a reality.
You're well done to the whole community who rallied round and backed the community group. Just been on the open deck bus tour around the base. It's got tremendous facilities and tremendous potential for attracting employment to the area.